Welcome to my Flosstube channel, Thread the Needle. My name is Vani and I am from Newfoundland, Canada. So in the past 2 weeks, it was the ending phase of the March bracket matchup that I did, my own version of it anyway. And it was a lot of fun, but at the same time, I was really itching to get back to all my other works and progresses because of course, with the March bracket matchup, you end up stitching on just the one project for days on end. And I'm surprised I lasted as long as I did. And I'm happy that I did it because I made a lot of progress on the winning project. But, oh my goodness, I couldn't wait to pick up another project to work on. But, so let's just dive back in and show you how much I got done. So as you all know, the project that won the bracket was Little Dreamer's Tree. And it's such a fun project to stitch on. It is very, very confetti heavy. However, because of the focus time that I was able to give it, I made a really nice bit of progress on it. So are you ready to see how much I've got done? So this is Little Dreamer's Tree, stitched on 18 count, 2/1 full cross. I am so happy with the progress I made. I think there was at least two full diagonals that I was able to fill, and then got halfway through filling in that third diagonal down here. But was able to get so much done, and I'm super happy. And if you can, there's a little elf or something in the tree there. It's wonderful. Such a lovely project. So I got a lot done, which I'm happy about, but I'm happy to get back to my work in progress rotation routine, right? So starting April 1st, I whipped out my little baggies of all of my works in progress is in there, and I pulled names out of a bag. So the first name that I pulled, and I was so excited. So I dabbled in the instructional video style. I did a few videos prior to my one that I did a few weeks ago, but I did just a couple where I described how I stitch my diagonal cross-country method. And the project that I used for that was the one I'm going to show you now. It's Mini Moose Crossing. And I don't think I've showed much of it on this Flosstube channel here. It's mostly just in those videos, but I've decided to put this project into my rotation because I have another plan for starting some Stitch With Me videos. Now, I don't even think I have a before picture for this, so we'll just go with what it is. So this is Mini Moose Crossing, and it just looks so real. The charting on this is, they've done such a fantastic job, and I can't even wait to get to the actual good stuff. And this is just the trees and the leaves and the pine needles. It's just wonderful. Like, the detail is superb, and it's such a joy to stitch on, so much fun. And I'm really glad that I got a chance to pull this one out and put it into my regular rotation. I put in 523 stitches on this one before I put it away. So then next in my rotation came Enchanted Garden. This is another one that I really enjoy stitching all the time whenever it comes up in my rotation. And I managed to put in 589 stitches before I put her away. And here is what she looks like now. So this one I stopped doing in any kind of particular stitching method, and I just went full on cross country method on this because this is the end of the project. So all I have left is this much left to fill in. So it's really, and I love these colors. The colors that are gonna come up in her skirt are the best. So I only have just, you know, that much to do. So I decided I'm just going to do full coverage on, oh my God, I keep saying the wrong words. I'm going to keep doing cross country on that, and I think we'll have a finish soon, which makes me feel better because I'm going to tell you about a new start that I'm going to have. Okay, so that's that. So since I only had the bracket winning project worked on, and then just a couple of whips because I started my whip rotation again in the beginning of April, I don't have a lot to show you except this, but I've got exciting news. I'm going to try and dabble in the more of the Stitch With Me videos. So I wanted to start a project from the very beginning, picking the project, picking the fabric, preparing the fabric, and starting with the very first stitch all the way through. And so the project that I selected, it's by one of my favorite artists on Heaven and Earth Designs. It's Rachel Anderson. And she always has such beautiful pieces. As you know, I'm already doing her birthstone series. And she has another three pieces that I've always wanted to stitch. They have been in my stash for a very long time. I have different versions of them. I bought the full version of this. This is Forget Me Not. And then I saw my other two that I like of hers is Lily of the Valley and then Rose. And I just felt like these three ladies would accompany each other really well. And so then I thought, I actually started long time ago, years ago, I actually started this one on like the full piece. It was ginormous. I actually did it on 22 count, I think. I barely got like a corner of the page right here done before I put it away because I was getting frustrated with it because it was just so large and it was just background and background and background before I even got to anything interesting. I hadn't even gotten that far. So it became a UFO, an unfinished object. And then more recently, in the last few years, I realized that she had QS versions of it, or Heaven and Earth Design had QS versions. So it was just the lady with a little bit of the flower and this, or in the other ones, it was just a cropped of just the fairy. And I thought, okay, that looks manageable. I can do that. And that was what my plan was. But of course I have so much in my whip rotation. I was like, not now. Eventually that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go do the QS versions of the three projects. Then more recently, when I was thinking about a project for my Stitch With Me videos, and I'm like, I want something that I'm gonna love stitching and something that's easy to follow along with that doesn't have a lot of confetti, but also can progress at a really nice rate. I decided to come back to these. And so I was like, I definitely don't wanna do the full version because that's like 400 by 600 stitches. It's like, that's not gonna happen. Then I looked at the QSs. I wasn't entirely happy because you were losing so much of the pretty stuff, the flowers, and the background helps. The background, you know, gives something to it. So then I checked again and all three of them have mini versions. So the mini version cuts the size down nicely. So you may lose a little bit of detail, but I'm doing a lot of minis. This is a mini. If the detail is like that, I'll take it. So, and the size of a mini makes it seem like the goal is attainable, that maybe in a few years I could actually finish this piece. So I'm gonna show you the other ones that are in that set of projects. Okay, so I screenshotted all three of the fairies, flower fairies that I wanna do from the Heaven and Earth Designs site. So you will see how well they go well with each other. They weren't meant to be grouped together, but I really feel like these three will look fantastic on the wall next to each other, okay? So we have mini forget-me-not. And if I was to do the QS, all I would get is the fairy and then a little bit of flower there and a little bit of flower that she's standing on. I wanted all of it. I wanted all of that forget-me-not flowers. Then the next one, which I feel pairs really nice with it, is called Mini Lily of the Valley. So there's this one. And the QS of this one was just her sitting on the mushroom with that flower with the droplet. And you miss the leaf and the snail. You miss all the other flowers. I was like, nope, I need the whole thing, but not the big version. So then finally, the third piece to this puzzle is Rose. Absolutely beautiful. And again, the crop was just her sitting on the flower. I wanted the whole picture just to get the feeling and the feel of it, of these tiny fairies sitting on these flowers. It's just beautiful. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start with, not Lily of the Valley, Forget Me Not. And the fabric that I have chosen is from Bestitch Me. And it's Anemone is the color name. I'm totally butchering that name, but here it is. It's like a purpley one. So I think that will go nicely with this. Oh, this is not gonna be easy. All right, so this is the fabric choice, and this is the picture. So I think, oh, it's gonna look gorgeous, beautiful. And so that is my plan for my Stitch Me With Me video. So give me some time and I'll get started on that. So basically I wanna show, this one is already pre-finished on the edges, so I won't have to show any of that kind of stuff. It's already nicely done, serged in the edges, and one is already a finished edge. But I will be showing how I measure to find my starting point, because the fabric measurement is supposed to be, I think 16 inches by 20. That's the size of fabric that you need for that project. And so this one is 18 by 21. So I'll show on a piece that's slightly larger, because I'm not going to cut it off that couple of inches here. And then I'm just going to keep it as extra fabric on my frame. So I'm going to discuss how you properly measure it in according to the way that I do it. Many people have other ways to do it, but this is just my way. So I'll talk about that. I'll start my gridding. And then in the next video, I'll start stitching and you can all stitch along with me. If you want to stitch the exact same project, great. If not, you're welcome to just listen and watch along while you do your own stitching. So that is the plans I have. I know, big lofty goals and plans. I don't know where I think I have all this time to do this kind of stuff, but that's the plan. Because I love stitching so much and it just brings me so much joy and I just want to do it all the time. And it's been so lovely. March flew by very quickly. But I'm very glad that April is here and I get to work on more of a variety of my projects. So it's gonna be very exciting. And I can't wait to share with you what I come up with in the next 2 weeks. It's been great. I know it's a short video today, but I think I shared a little bit of my plans and a little bit of my stitching. So I think it was lots of fun and I can't wait to see you again next time. So thank you, my friends, for joining me here today. It has been wonderful. Have a great day, or evening or night, and I will see you all next time. Bye.